how do we deal with the shovel-ready part? Because how is that going to be approved? I think I heard someone say it's by right if this happens. And if I own a piece of property and I decide I want to pre-grade it, but I haven't got a buyer, I haven't got a sniff of a buyer, but I want it pre-graded because it's more valuable, but it could sit there for who knows how long. Did you consider making it within 100 feet of residential like you did on the open house and some of the others? Because whether it's right or not, we've seen it on the proposed annexation and others. People love the fact that a non-developed land looks like non-developed land.
When we say by right, what we mean is whether it's grading or it's a use that we're permitting, is that if you meet all of the criteria in the zoning code, you have to meet all of the criteria in the zoning code, then you are granted by right. But you first have to, if you will, jump through the hoops of what the code stipulations are, and then it is granted by right.
No, I understand that, but it still could be there for 10 years graded.
That's true. As written, that is the case.
That's my point. And it can still be there for 10 years within 100 feet of a house. So I really would like us to look at that and see if we lose something, if we put a more of a restriction in terms of being near. Malini, I understand your point of money having even playing fields, but they aren't even. We're already treating them differently if they're within 100 feet of residential. And there is a reason for that.
So is there a limit to how long a site could sit pre-graded? Potentially no, correct?
Correct. As it is, there is not a limit on the time that a property can sit pre-graded.
So we already currently allow pre-grading of sites that are not highly visible or not close to neighbors. So that's not what would be changed with this code amendment, right?
That's not being changed, no.
So this code amendment would change more highly visible sites or those closer to neighbors. Is that correct?
Well, it does not only that, but it also allows it by right. So we would be, if council adopted this amendment, granting the right to pre-grade.
What I would like to see, because I think we're all thinking the same thing, and this is really complex, so I think it'd be helpful to have examples of what shovel-ready looks like, whether it's in the, residential areas or non-residential areas. Actually, both would be good. And the codes as we have them now would be helpful to have in there, as we've discussed, so it's completely laid out for us to see and make the comparisons. That would really be helpful.